This week, we leave Marsh Harbour in the middle of the night to start our journey south. Along the way, we meet a pod of pilot whales, hang out with turtles, visit a pink sand beach, break a sail, and return to Cat Island, where we celebrate Thanksgiving and prepare for a longer journey east.
Cause even in the madness, there's peace, drowning out the voices all around me. Through all of this chaos, you are writing a symphony.
After checking into the Bahamas, getting fuel and resting for a day, we're headed back out for the next leg of our journey. We're heading back out to anchor near the cut, so our exit will be easier. We're planning to leave after sunset.
Right here, if you can.
It's 10 o'clock and we just pulled up anchor and we are leaving Marsh Harbor. We needed to leave in the middle of the night because we wanted to time our arrival at Harbour Island so that we can get through a cut there that's a little bit more difficult to do than most places. So we got to do an overnight to get there.
As overnights go, this one was really easy and we were greeted with calm seas, a few showers, and some rainbows. We were also greeted by a pod of pilot whales, so we had to stop and watch them slowly pass us by. This is the northern end of Eleuthera Island. Typically, the wind blows from the east, making it difficult getting to Harbour Island, which is here. When the wind is like this, people generally follow this route from Spanish Wells, and it's tough. There's a lot of coral, and if you haven't been, you should hire a pilot to get you through it. As luck would have it, the weather was good to approach from the east, so we took that route. In the end, we took it slow and it was straightforward but quite shallow. We got in the harbor and we were ready to explore a new area of the Bahamas for us. The next morning, we went to town and rented golf carts to explore the area. We went to a couple of shops, including a hardware store, to replace an air conditioner part that I broke. It didn't work. Then we headed over to the pink sand beach. That, we drove over to the driftwood tree. We're told it's a tree that washed in during a storm and stood itself up right offshore. We stopped in town and grabbed some lunch, then went back to the boats to play cards. And we went to a happy hour, but I didn't film any of that. The next morning, we were off to see some turtles. There's a spot at the southern end of the bay where they congregate. That is not a turtle tail. It's a remora. You see them on sharks, but I didn't know they like turtles. Did you see that? Sneaky suckers. After seeing the turtles, it was time to head out. Our weather window was closing for us to get to our next stop, Cat Island. So we headed back out the cut. This was another overnight, and the waves and storms were not the best.
Well, that was miserable. We left Harbour Island yesterday at about 4 p.m., sailed overnight to Cat Island, which is here. And it was just a bad combination of angle and wind and waves. And we just got the crap handed to us most of the night. It was miserable. We got slammed around so much, it broke, I'm calling it a halyard, but it's like the halyard on the bottom of the Code Zero sail. And that broke this morning just because it had been pounding so much. So yeah, we're ready to get there. We have to go through a cut. So we're waiting for some daylight so that we can see what we're doing in there because the charts say you need to be able to see things, and we've never been through it before.
We settled in at Fernandez Bay and made a quick run to the grocery store there in the morning. As Bahamian groceries go, it was really well stocked. I'd highly recommend it.
We're making a quick hop around the corner to New Bite, and it's, you know, like an hour or two, and there's a nice little wind. Not worth bothering with the main, but put the Genoa up and we're getting 5 knots, and it's just calm and peaceful because we're in the lee of Cat Island, and so there are no waves. It's awesome up here. And we're ahead of Seascape. Totally whipping them.
We cracked out our boat show purchase, a sun chill. All went well until we spotted a shark fin circling our boat. We've now renamed this thing the Shark Bowl. We had a few boat tasks to take care of, so we knocked some of those out. We fixed the Code Zero and put that away. Topped off the fuel tanks from the cans. Then refilled all of those cans and Seascapes too. Did some laundry. Stopped and got a chicken in a bag that was amazing. Paid a visit to Olive's Bakery and got lots of goodies, including fresh rolls for Thanksgiving. And then we headed over to Olive's Church to check out the progress they've made since we were last here. And they're almost done. After 20 years of work, they're in the final stages. A lot of hard work by a lot of folks has gone into it, and it's exciting seeing it wrap up.
What do you think, Willie? Isn't this cool? Did you come to church perhaps?
We did a lot of other stuff while we were there, but it was mostly walking and eating out. There's something about Cat Island that we love. It's hard to put your finger on it. The last thing we did before leaving Cat was prepare and eat a proper Thanksgiving meal. It was pretty amazing what our two boats came up with, and we were full for days afterwards. We have a lot to be thankful for, and I can't imagine a better place to celebrate that than Cat Island. Hey everybody, thanks for watching. We're home for Christmas right now, so we probably won't get the next video done until the first week of January. But keep an eye out for it. We leave the Bahamas for the Dominican Republic, but end up sailing 6 days straight all the way to the British Virgin Islands. Thanks again, and we'll see you after Christmas.